And now I'm honored to introduce my friends, poets and translators, Window, Jensen, and Jing Lu. Window is my friend since 1990. We are colleagues in journalism and poetry in Saigon. He went to the U.S. in the 1990. And after a meeting for Hoover, they cooperate one another to make a big project introducing Vietnamese poetry into American readers. And they have published two books. One is Black Love, Black Night, Contemporary Vietnamese Poetry, and the second, just recently published, is Beyond the Court Gate, poems of one of the most important, the biggest figure of the history and poetry of Vietnam, Nguyễn Trãi. And now, and we don't want to read some poems by Nguyễn Trãi, and you can have some echoes of the past of Vietnam.
Thank all people. Big, big, amazing crowd here. So, Paul Hoover and I have been doing four projects so far. All translation Vietnamese poetry into English, American English. The first project is Black Dog, Black Night, Contemporary Vietnamese Poetry. Included 15 poems on the, you guys can see in the back. And the second project is Beyond Poet, Selected Wintertime Poetry, one of the most important, the greatest poet of the Vietnam. And we have two other projects, and now we doing on the field projects. That's a 4,000 year Vietnamese poetry. So I'm one poem in Vietnamese, my heart language, and poem in English, my his tongue language, his tongue, my heart. Một buổi chiều đứng ngắm. Trời rộng bao la, nước dài bát ngát. Núi sông thu về vàng lá phủ ngập tràn. Bỗng chúng ta thèm được chết như đôi chim trắng ở dưới cành hoa kia, nơi trò đời không cách nào chạm đến.
Standing to watch the afternoon. The sky is too wide and the water is endless. Yellow leaves fall, covering all space between mountains and rivers. I wish to die beside a blossom over there, like two even whiter birds did, since nothing involving life comes to that quietness.
And the second one is your own poem.
Okay, you persuade me. Are you gonna read
I'm gonna read in English, and you read in English first.
Oh.
Okay.
I read in English first?
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm going to read in Vietnamese. You got a good English.
It's all right. This is from a book called Poems in Spanish. They were written as if in Spanish, but they were written in English. And so then you're going to hear it in Vietnamese. Plus, they were just published in Mexico City in Spanish. So that was good. The Road. My father endures me. With his soft fists and fat Bible, he beats me and beats me. He throws the sheep in my direction, all thistles and thorns, and yet every evening I must wash his feet in the flood. Only death could take him, with its hands the size of a child, only death with its style. Now he sleeps in sweetness. He disappears and reappears like the cat you never see. How often I see him at the back of some cafe, a minor god in black sunglasses eating his spaghetti, strands of it on his shoulders and also in his hair. Nothing is for certain, even the uncertain. And my mother is always passing, with her taste of other tastes, of paper, bees, and sharpness. Something in her is so solid, so easy to hold in the mind, but I can feel it breaking. I wait and wait with only speed to keep me on roads that curve into whiteness. My parents walk as fast as they can, their shadows flying behind them, but keep getting farther away. There is solitude in the halls of a palace where tourists carry their faces. There is solitude in reason, but on the green field, everything is present, all kinds of speech just beneath the ear.
Our Vietnamese, no? I hope nobody understands Vietnamese. Con đường, this is on the road, like Jack Kerouac, con đường. Bố tôi thúc tôi bằng nắm đấm mềm và cuốn thánh kinh dày cộp. Ông phang tôi tới tấp, lùa đàn cừu về hướng tôi đi, nơi đầy cỏ gai nhọn sắc. Rồi chiều mỗi chiều tôi rửa hai bàn chân ông lấm đầy bùn đất, và chỉ có bàn tay thần chết mới giúp được ông. Thôi bùa vây thằng bé, thần chết mang đi bằng cái cách của nó. Nhưng bây giờ bố ơi, bố đang ngon giấc ở chốn nao ngọt ngào mê mệt. Bố biến đi rồi bố hiện ra, như chẳng thể nào bắt gặp con mèo nhà ta. Rồi khi nào con lại nhìn thấy bố, đâu đấy đằng sau một góc quán nhỏ như chúa tể nghênh ngang kính mát, ngồi ăn spaghetti, dăm sợi vương trên vai, vài sợi dính lên tóc. Mọi thứ như là có, mọi thứ như là không. Mà mẹ tôi thì thường lướt nhanh hết thứ nọ sang đến kia, hết thử nọ sang đến kia, nào giấy còn mật lưa dao sắc, trong bà mọi thứ cứ như là bất biến, dễ dàng nằm sẵn trong đầu. Thế mà tôi lại thấy đâu đây vỡ nứt. Tôi đợi, tôi chờ, chỉ có thời gian mới ngăn được tôi. Trên con đường dần dần trở nên trắng vắng, bố mẹ tôi bước thật nhanh như trốn, cái bóng chính người lấp lấy đuổi sau lưng, mỗi lúc càng xa càng xa. Đó là cảm giác cô đơn của khách thăm đang đứng ở một hành lang mênh mông cung điện. Mình mang chính muôn khuôn mặt mình, một nỗi đơn độc có lý. Nhưng mà cỏ vẫn xanh, mọi thứ vẫn xanh kia, tất cả dưới tai tôi vẫn đang thủ thỉ.
Thank you, Doug.